Good evening and welcome to the Pittsburg Multi-Generational Choir's Television Hit Parade. Couple notes before we begin. First, we ask that you hold your applause until the very end of tonight's performance. Having heard these songs, I can tell you that will not be easy. Please hold your applause until the end, and then you are free to do as you please. Second note, smiling during tonight's performance is both permitted and encouraged, and in fact, I believe unavoidable. Some of these songs and memories will make you smile. You will not be able to control yourself. That's okay. We understand. Now, the opening theme of a television show has a tall order to achieve. In 60 seconds, it must lure you into spending the next 30 or 60 minutes of viewing pleasure. Set the standard with memorable melodies and catchy lyrics that are still recognized today. 1941 during a baseball game on a local channel in New York. It was a 10-second commercial advertising bullet hole watches. It cost a mere $4. But it completely revolutionized both television and advertising. Viewers became loyal and devoted to many products, especially when it came to automobile dealers and gasoline stations. Considerable time watching TV, and there were an abundance of programs to choose from. Television viewing soared, and restaurant and theater attendance plummeted. Every network promoted westerns. Maverick, Cheyenne, Gunsmoke, Bonanza, Daniel Boone, Davy Crockett, Rawhide, The Big Valley, and The Wild Wild West, to name a few. Commercials were full of sex appeal and glamour for America's social vices.
We're all
popular programming included variety shows such as Ed Sullivan, Your Show of Shows, Bob Hope, Smothers Brothers, and Carol Burnett. Situation comedy favorites, I Love Lucy, MASH, Mary Tyler Moore, and All in the Family. Popular Law and Order shows, The Streets of San Francisco, The Naked City, The Bold Ones, Perry Mason, and The Untouchables. And medical dramas, Ben Casey, Marcus Welby, Dr. Kildare, and Medical Center. Producers were saturating the network with new programs, and as a result, quality of writing and acting performance often suffered. It is easy to refer to early programs as old-fashioned and ridiculous, but the same could probably be said someday looking back at our programming today. The commercials will certainly give you some. Frank Lloyd Wright believed TV is chewing gum for the eyes. And Dan Rather concluded, an intellectual snob is someone who can listen to the William Tell Overture and not think of the Lone Ranger. With unique hosts and themes. Programs typically aired in the weekday mornings before and after school. Almost all shows had a colorful host who assumed a persona such as a cowboy, cowgirl, captain, skipper, commodore, admiral, jungle explorer, astronaut, king, princess, clown, etc. Popular broadcasts included Captain Kangaroo, Howdy Doody, Romper Room, Soupy Sales, The Sherry Lewis Show, Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood, Sesame Street, The Electric Company, and The Paul Winchell Show. Attracting a mature audience through more adult humor. Theme music was often commissioned from a composer and was orchestral and sophisticated in nature, leaving the quirky content to the cartoon itself.
Yeah! clap makes the world go round. Snap, rice and peas.
High seats crackle the crispy sound. You gotta have crackle or the clock got wound. Geese, caterpillars, tinkle bells, buckle beats, tinkle, but crackle makes the world go round.
Snap, crackle on rice and peas.
I insist that pops the sound. The best is Mr. Les Pops around. You can't stop popping when the cereal's popping. Pop makes the world go round.
Snap, crackle, Rice Krispies.
High seats crackle,
the pops are sound.
Gobble, crackle,
sauce abound.
Flash and fire, twinkle bells,
bubble,
snap, crackle,
makes the world go round.
Snap, crackle, pop, Rice Krispies.
During these two decades, 29 made their way into the top 60 on the Billboard Singles Chart. Some made it all the way to number one, including Welcome Back, Cotter, Ballad of Jed Clampett from Beverly Hillbillies, and instrumental themes, Dukes of Hazzard and Miami Vice. Theme songs now served as an explanatory anecdote for the show, describing precisely what the viewer would experience.
Oh,
Back when we had to leave the couch to change the channel, the opening sequence of a show remained its audition for the next 30 minutes of our attention. Should we spend some more time with Richie and the Fonz? Or flip over to the Tony Orlando and Don Rainbow Hour? The opening and closing theme music became an art form. A 1968 novel about three doctors' misadventures in a mobile army surgical hospital during the Korean War. Upon analyzing the script, Altman was aware that he was walking a tightrope between slapstick and tragedy. He called on his friend, composer Johnny Mandel, to write a song for actor Ken Primus to sing while playing the guitar. Altman's two stipulations, the song had to be called Suicide is Painless, and it had to be, quote, the stupidest song ever written. With great reluctance, Mandel wrote the music. Altman struggled crafting a scene that would successfully combine an easy-listening style, scenes of helicopters, stretchers, carnage, and patients in pain. But somehow, it did. Happy Days also wrote the spinoff of Vernon Shirley theme song. They originally wrote the song as "Hoping Our Dreams Will Come True," but changed it to "Making Our Dreams Come True," when producers told them that these two independent women don't hope, they go out and make things happen. Affirm her optimistic character, beginning with the iconic line, "Who can turn the world on with her smile?" And concluding with a more definitive, "You're gonna make it after all." Mary's famous hat toss at the end of the sequence is perhaps one of television's greatest moments.
Who can turn the world on?
The Jeffersons was a spinoff of All in the Family, in which the bonkers black next-door neighbors moved to a deluxe apartment in the sky. This gospel-tinged song, written by Jenny Dubois and Jeff Berry, described their progression on up. Ms. Dubois played the role of the Jefferson's maid on the show, and also re-recorded the theme song. Her backup gospel choir consisted of 35 black churchgoers. Dubois said of this song, quote, "I know about black folks moving up. I've been there."
Well, we're moving on.
Sebastian, founder of the Love and Spoonful, had difficulty writing the theme song lyrics. He couldn't find enough writing words for the title. He decided to compose lyrics that illustrated the premise of the show in a song called Welcome Back. The producers were so impressed with the song that they decided to change the series title to Welcome Back, Carter. The song was also re-released on a single which went to number one on the charts.
Yeah.
theme song for Three's Company was written by Joe Raposo, who also wrote Sesame Street and The Electric Company. The producers wanted the stars of the cast to sing the theme song. Despite their protests, Ritter, DeWitt, and Summers attempted it, but didn't do it justice. So other singers were hired for the job. The silly banter in lyrics is no easy jingle to sing. The song tells of the transient life of a radio professional moving from market to market in search of a better gig, unable to settle down. A very melancholy tune that could relate to characters on the show, as the singer is telling his girl that he once again is moving on and all he can hope is that she'll think of him once in a while.